the book Liz and Eugene and the South of the School Orbit by Stephen Quince. Early in the morning of April 18, 1906, a 10-year-old Arjun Gupta was asleep in his grandmother's apartment. His grandmother was sick and Arjun had stage fright company. Arjun was having a bad dream. He was riding on a train, but it didn't feel safe. The tracks were moving up and down in the air. He was being tossed from side to side.
Ah!
Arjun awoke screaming. He was shaking from head to toe, but not from the dream. His whole room was shaking violently. It was just after 5 o'clock in the morning, and the sky was still dark outside.
Grandma, what is going on?
The room continued to shake. Pictures fell from the walls and furniture tipped over. The large mirror fell off the dresser and landed at the foot of Arjun's bed.
Grandma!
Arjun raced to his grandma's bed. Grandma was still lying in bed, and a piece of the ceiling was lying there with her. Grandma's head was bleeding badly. Arjun rushed to her side and pushed the plaster away.
Grandma, are you all right?
What hit me? Oh my goodness, it's an earthquake. We are not safe in here. Help me, Arjun. We need to get outside in case the building collapses.
As they opened the front door, Arjun gasped. He couldn't believe what had happened to his grandmother's street. Some buildings lay crumbled in heaps. Panicked people poured out of doorways and into the street, yelling and screaming. For a second, Arjun stood motionless in shock.
What do you do now, Grandma?
As an ambulance wagon came clattering down the street, Arjun shouted and waved his arms. The driver pulled on the reins to bring the horses to a stop.
The ambulance is almost full. I have room for just one more person.
That would be me. You go on home, Arjun. I will be fine at the hospital. Your mother must be worried sick. The sooner you find your mother, the better.
Arjun shivered. It was strange to feel so alone with so many people around, but nobody was paying any attention to him. As he made his way toward home, the quakes kept coming. These aftershocks were not as strong as the earthquake itself, but cracks and holes were still opening near Arjun's feet. When Arjun finally reached home, all he could do for a moment was stand and stare in amazement. His apartment building had partly collapsed and the front door was blocked.
Mother, is anyone there?
No one answered.
Now what am I going to do? Think, Arjun. Mom always says the brain's only good if you exercise it every once in a while.
Oh, I remember. The St. Francis Hotel. Mom said we should meet at the St. Francis Hotel in emergency.
Arjun's mother worked at the St. Francis Hotel. As Arjun hurried on, the smoke began to gather like fog. He heard bits of conversations from the people he passed. City Hall was burning along with everything south of Market Street. Hundreds, possibly thousands of people had already died. Arjun sighed with relief when he finally reached Union Square. His feet ached, but that didn't matter. The St. Francis was standing as it always had. As he approached the hotel's front door, his mother rushed out.
Arjun, you're all right? Thank goodness you're not hurt. I've been keeping watch. I was afraid we might miss you in all the confusion.
What do you do now?
We could stay here, but it may be safer to move away from the fires. The head of housekeeping lives up on Russian Hill. Her house was not damaged, and she's offered to take us in.
After making sure Grandma was safe in the hospital, the Guptas went to stay with the head of housekeeping. That night, they looked out from the top of Russian Hill. A bright moon was shining over the bay, but down in the city, hundreds of fires were burning. The flames looked almost alive, leaping up from roofs and spires.
The worst may not be over, but San Francisco will rise again.
More than 100 years later now, the San Francisco earthquake is still an important event in California history and U.S. history. The 7.9 magnitude earthquake was felt from northern Oregon down the length of California and as far east as central Nevada. A lot of the damage was caused by the fires that came after the earthquake. 4.5 square miles of the city were burned.
The St. Francis Hotel, which is left standing after the earthquake, was destroyed by fire.
Historians believe close to 3,000 people may have died because of the earthquake and the fires that followed.
As many as 300,000 people were left homeless after that. people of San Francisco to rebuild their city. Earthquakes are part of the city. Past its roof. But thanks to the lessons learned from the 1906 quake, people and buildings are better prepared for that. The end.